Human body parts is big business in Africa. I escaped hundreds of axe, sword, and dagger wielding assailants in Cape Town, South Africa, who wanted to cut me up for my body parts to sell to the witch doctor. Welcome to the Paranormal Life channel. Click like and subscribe. I'm Fuad Rahman. I'm a journalist from Cape Town, South Africa. I also had a narrow escape in Nairobi, Kenya inside a dance venue and pub called the Green Bar. Three seemingly nice guys wanted to incapacitate me so they could sell my body organs on the black market. Luckily, I noticed one of the three guys slipped a drug into my coffee and when I wanted to clobber them, they disappeared. Also, in the remote northern villages in Tanzania I was rescued by an overland truck driver and his crew from a cannibal and human-eating villagers. I'm extremely lucky to tell my story. I reported my story in the newspapers. In Cape Town recently a child and a woman went missing on the same day. They have not been found. Hundreds who went missing are never located. In Durban in the province of KwaZulu-Natal voodoo practices are so frequent the police opened an occult department to handle cases of unknown origin. The witch doctor can cast the future by throwing bones. Human bones are sometimes used to predict the future or to create magic spells, but most often these bones are just animal bones. I have been inside a witch doctor's hut. There a human skull, a brewing pot, some herbs, dead insects, paper, material like linen and photographs. I could smell strong incense and a brew coming from the pot. Other than that, there were several people lining up to pay the witch doctor for a magic spell. Voodoo is serious business in Southern Africa. I have been through Southern Africa and witnessed voodoo magic in Lusaka in Zambia and also in places in Malawi. The voodoo magic is invoked through dancing until the witch doctor goes into a deep trance. Little children get killed for magic potion for witch doctors in South Africa. In a recent times, thousands of little children are missing and never found. There are no clues to their whereabouts and grieving families never have full closure. In a town near Johannesburg there were mass killings of little children recently. One accused who believed to have killed two children admitted in court he killed the children to sell as muti. He said the witch doctor paid him for the body parts of the little children. Local people do not believe in medical treatment as such. Most consult voodoo and witch doctors. The witch doctors are both male and female and they are revered in their communities. They call it muti in South Africa. Muti is a Zulu word meaning tree. The tree is considered part of human origin and denotes life and existence with its deep roots. The tree also denotes reincarnating back into life from the underworld. Muti is a much sought-after magic potent in South Africa and all of Southern Africa. Parts of the baby's body are being used in the muti to create the magic spells. The voodoo is a popular remedy for sickness, incurable disease, and even as a love spell. Some witch doctors only use herbal treatment but a lot make use of the body parts of little children. The witch doctor plays a huge role in the culture of the people of the Zulu, Xhosa, and other indigenous cultures here. This magic comes along for many, many centuries. Rock art in ancient caves denotes the presence of the witch doctor centuries back. There are both the white magic and the black magic. Some witch doctors make use of demonic entities to cast spells like hurting someone, while the good voodoo doctor as he or she is called, would invoke the ancestors to work good magic. Many witch doctors now even have their own websites where they can be contacted, through a simple Google search. Even the historical figure who fought against the European invader known as Shaka Zulu had his own personal witch doctors. There was a movie made about Shaka Zulu. Not many cases are solved.